Welcome back to my channel, Statistics for Applied Linguistics. I'm Dr. Marnie Menegra, and in this video, we are going to continue with inferential statistics. We're going to look at the Z test and the T test. And of course, the question is, how do I know which of these tests to choose? So here is my flowchart here. Let's start with your data. Do you have either one sample or two samples? So do you only have one class of students, or do you have two classes of students? Or with two samples, you could have one class of students with two different tests. So let's start with the one sample. If you only have one sample, but you already know the population standard deviation, then you would use a Z-test. Now, Z-tests used to be very popular back when we used to have to do all of the statistics by hand. Now, because we're using JASP, and in this course we're using JASP, JASP doesn't even have the Z statistic built in where the t-tests are. So, and it's very, very rare that you would know the standard deviation. So a one sample t-test is if you do not know the population standard deviation, which is normal. So if you only have one sample and you don't know the standard deviation, you're going to use a one sample t-test. An example of this would be comparing your group of students, what their test scores look like, to an already known data set, which might be the national average on a standardized test. Now, a two samples t-test. Paired means that the two different samples have to be twinned. And there's two ways of doing this. You could have two groups that you match exactly. So let's say if you have two females at the same height with blonde hair, blue eyes, and then you split them into two different groups, and then you've got two males with the same height, dark hair, same eye color, you can do it that way. Or you could take two sets of identical, or you could, let's say if you have 26 sets of identical twins, and you split the twins into two separate groups. That's paired, that's matched. What you will find more common for a paired samples t-test is if you use the exact same students, but you only have one class and you do a pre-test post-test design. Now, keep in mind, if you are doing a pre-test post-test design and it is paired, they have to have the exact same number of participants in each group. So on a pre-test post-test design with the same students, you would then need to eliminate any students who did not do both tests. They have to match exactly. Now, for a two samples t-test, which is an independent samples t-test, this is if the data is not paired. So this would be in the case that you have two completely different groups or two completely different classes of students, one class at one school and one class at another school, and you want to compare what these two groups of students are doing on, let's say, a standardized test. That would be an independent samples t-test. Okay, so let's have a look at this here. We've got a little bit more vocabulary. Now, remember that t-tests are statistical hypothesis tests, and a statistical hypothesis is a statement about a parameter of a population we are interested in. A statistical hypothesis test begins with two hypotheses, and we've discussed this in the video on how to write your hypothesis statements. So we have your null hypothesis, which again states there is no significant difference between specified populations, and your alternative hypothesis, which states there's a significant difference between specified populations. Now, we also have one-sided hypothesis tests and two-sided hypothesis tests. So examples of the one-sided hypothesis tests are the two images at the top, just on the left-hand side here, where we're only interested if one group is performing at a higher level than the other, or one group is performing at a lower level than the other. A two-sided hypothesis test, on the other hand, is looking at, we don't know whether the participants are going to perform higher or lower, so it could go in either direction. So now we're going to look at the Z test. This is the equation for the Z test. Again, we used to do these by hand. I've included a link in this PowerPoint presentation on how to do this by hand if you're interested in. But again, this is when you only have one sample and you do not know the standard deviation. So the Z test statistic allows us to know the distribution of the test statistic to conduct a hypothesis test under the assumption that the null hypothesis is true. And this is the T test statistic. So this is what the formula looks like if you want to do this by hand. And I have a link to the video in the PowerPoint presentation. But the t-test, we do not know the population standard deviation. I'm going to have separate videos showing how to do a one sample t-test, a paired samples t-test, and an independent samples t-test. Those will be three separate videos showing how to do those in JASP. But for a one sample t-test, again, you're using this to compare the mean of a sample to the mean of a population. So the example which I sort of already gave was I want to compare the mean on the final exam of a course at URV to the mean of a final exam for the course across Catalonia to see if my students are performing similarly to the general population who takes this exam. So again, this will be a two-tailed test because I don't know the direction that the difference will be. And we also need to know the mean of comparison. So I would need to know what the mean across Catalonia is. So what is the mean or arithmetic mean or average of the students who take this exam across Catalonia? And then I'm going to use my students and we're going to compare that. A two sample t-test unpaired. So this would be an independent samples t-test. And this assumes the two samples are independent of one another so that the values of one does not affect the values of the other. So again, a two sample t-test unpaired is an independent samples t-test. This is the formula here. So for an independent samples t-test or two sample t-test unpaired, this again is comparing two classes. One class received a lesson using grammar translation method, and the other class received a lesson using a mobile app on the same vocabulary set. So we want to know if the samples are different, not which ones are better. Therefore, it is a non-directional two-tailed test. And the null hypothesis is that the two samples are equal, and the alternative hypothesis is that the two samples are not equal. Okay, finally, the paired samples t-test. So the paired samples t-test, also known as matched pairs, unlike the independent samples t-test, the samples are paired. So there is one of each kind in each group. So here's another example. Each class has one bilingual female French English, one bilingual male French English, one bilingual female Spanish English, one bilingual male Spanish English, two monolingual females, and two monolingual males. So you're looking at making sure that each of the classes match based on whichever variables you're interested in. The groups are matched exactly, and this is a control. So the matched pairs means the samples are not independent, and the degrees of freedom differ here, where n minus one is the number of pairs minus one. So you're going to get a different degrees of freedom here, where the degrees of freedom in the independent samples t-test is the general number minus one. In the paired samples, it's the number of pairs minus one. So this is going to be slightly different. Okay, so again, I'm going to show each of these videos separately on how to conduct each of these tests in JASP, the three different t-tests, but this video explains how to choose which t-test. And thank you so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.